This is Mark, chapter 12.
Salah. You got a question?
You talking about some stop.
Stop what? What should I stop? You said what?
Continue.
I mean, I can't hear you way over there, man. Come over here and talk to me like a man, man.
Bunch of cowards, man.
Or you can walk up the block like a coward that you are.
That's right.
Read.
Mark chapter 12, verse 29. And Jesus answered him, "The first of all the commandments is here, O Israel, the Lord our God is one Lord. And thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, and with all thy soul, and with all thy mind, and with all thy strength. This is the first commandment. And the second is like, namely this, thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself."
Hey yo, sis, what are you doing, sis? What are you doing? You know damn well you need to start walking with the devil, man. What the hell is going on, man? Mad prophecy is popping off, man. Like, what the hell is going on? He reading.
Zaddy got that money.
Thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself.
Thou shalt do what?
Love thy neighbor as thyself.
Okay. That's it on that?
There is no other commandment greater than these.
There is no other commandment greater than loving the Most High and loving your neighbor as yourself, man. But who is your neighbor? Right? Who is your neighbor? You got what I want?
Bring that out.
Bring it out. Let's see.
It's the book of Leviticus, chapter 19 and verse 16. Uh-huh. Thou shalt not go up and down as a talebearer among thy people.
Yeah, man. No, like, none of that gossiping, man. None of that he say, she say nonsense, man. Right? Because we understand that gets people put to death, man. That gets, that leads to bearing a false witness, man. Read.
Neither shalt thou stand against the blood of thy neighbor.
Man, that's showing you, man, that you're supposed to be ready to put your life on the line for your own people, man. Right? You should be ready to put your life on the line for your fellow Israelite, man. Read.
Thou shalt not hate thy brother in thy heart. Thou shalt in any wise rebuke thy neighbor and not suffer sin upon him. Thou shalt not avenge nor bear any grudge against the children of thy people, but thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself.
Yeah, man, so that's showing you who your neighbor is, man, right? A fellow Israelite, man, right? That descends from one of the 12 tribes, man. That is your neighbor, man. So it's high time to start loving your neighbor, man. It's high time to start rebuking your neighbor without thinking of putting him to death, man. It's too much death going on in Chicago, man, right? What's going on?
I'm Daniel the prophet. Modern day prophet.
You a prophet?
Daniel the modern day prophet.
Give me Deuteronomy 18 and I think it's 21 or something. Hey yo, you talking
right
to
here.
Me?
I'm right here.
Talking to me.
Right here.
What's your nationality? On your father's side.
My father is French Lithuanian. My mother is 100% Irish.
Okay. So you said that you're a prophet?
Daniel, the modern day prophet.
Okay, so what are you prophesying about? So what are you prophesying about? Give me
God honors me by speaking through me.
Okay, so prophesy something to me right now.
You're a good man. I'm trying to get funds in your church to make this world better.
You got on one? Okay, read that. Hold on, let me see. Read.
This is the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 18 and verse 21. And if thou say in thine heart, how shall we know the word which the Lord hath not spoken? When a prophet speaketh in the name of the Lord.
In what?
When a prophet speaketh in the name of the Lord. Uh-huh. If the thing follow not, nor come to pass. That is the thing which the Lord hath not spoken. But the prophet hath spoken it presumptuously. Thou shalt not be afraid of him.
Okay, man, so that's telling you what a prophet does, right? A real prophet, what does a prophet do, first of all? Give me that Jeremiah.
He's a professor. He guards knowledge.
So how many prophets do you know that smoke cigarettes?
I'm stupid.
I agree.
God speaks through me, so I'm too dumb to know that. But he gives a message to someone that they need. That's what he does, and I'm honored by that.
Okay, hold on. So let me ask you this question, right? You got something to say?
God got this. He's the best pharmacist in the world. Isn't God the best pharmacist?
Hold on, read.
If you love the Alpha and Omega,
this is Jeremiah, chapter 14, verse 15. Therefore, thus saith the Lord concerning the prophets that prophesied in my name. I sent them not, yet they say, sword and famine shall not be in this land. By sword and famine shall those prophets be consumed.
Yo, hey, Daniel, the prophet. Did you hear what he just said? So I got a question for you. What do prophets do? According to the Bible, what does a prophet do?
Prophet is a vessel for the Lord's knowledge.
No, I mean it can, but according to the Bible.
The Lord speaks through a prophet.
I agree, but what is his role? What is his role in the world?
He's
as being a prophet.
Connection between heaven and God.
Hold on, here you go.
Life on earth.
So
he gives God knowledge to let you know that that's him. And I'm too stupid to know that.
According to the Bible. According to the Bible, who can be a prophet? What nation of people can be prophets?
Anybody God chooses.
Anybody God chooses. Right?
Even a dumbass like me.
Right.
No good.
Let's see what qualifies you to be a prophet.
This is Jeremiah 28:8.
I give him my heart.
Listen, the prophets that have been before.
Why are you talking over the Bible? You believe in the Bible, don't you? Okay, then don't talk over the Bible. I respect the Bible. Read.
The prophets that have been before me and before thee of old prophesied against many countries.
That's not what I want. Give me, he would show his word unto Jacob.
Okay.
That's what I do. He said he's a prophet, right? You say you're Daniel,
no,
a prophet.
No, he said I'm a prophet.
Who?
I'm not.
Who the hell is he? That. Who is he?
He told me.
Who is he?
My God, my Savior.
You talked to God? You heard God?
My Lord, my Savior.
You heard God. He talked to you directly.
Yes.
You did?
That's spiritual wisdom. All right. Months,
remember you said you heard God.
3 years.
Remember you said you heard
three
God.
3 years.
Go ahead.
This is Psalms chapter 147, verse 19. He showeth his word unto Jacob.
Show him his word unto Jacob. Jacob is the progenitor of the Israelites. Read.
His statutes and his judgments unto Israel. He hath not dealt so with any nation. So
unless you're an Israelite, you can't be a prophet.
Ooh. Right.
Am I not? Step back,
you know,
six feet, man.
Six feet.
You told me your people were French. You told me your people were French, right?
Can I ask you a question?
You told me your people were French, right?
He said, where did all life originate? From the center of Africa. So am I not an Israelite? Lineage? Am I not?
Are you an Israelite? You're saying you are?
That's automatic.
You say you are?
All life conceived from that.
All life conceived from that. Let me show you who you are. Give me Genesis 25:25. Right? Also give me no man have heard God in the so-called New Testament. He said, and he directly talked to God. So we're going to see what the Bible has to say about that.
Save my life.
Let me show you who your people are. You say your people go back to the French and the Irish, right?
Save my life. Because
the book of Genesis 23. Okay, Genesis 25:25. And the first came out red all over like in hairy garment.
Red all over like a hairy garment, man. What baby comes out red all over? Blood showing forth through his skin.
I like them hairy garments.
Smooth. Hey, you hairy like them hairy garments, aren't you? Your blood shows forth through your skin, man. That's a mutation, man. You knew that?
Oh, I know.
That's a recessive gene. That's a recessive gene. To be one of God's children, you have to be from the seed of Isaac. Can you prove to us that you're from the seed of Isaac? You mean the seed of Jacob?
Let me ask you a question.
How are you a child of God? Is everybody a child of God? What makes you a child of God?
Automatic.
Okay.
We're all built in His image.
The Bible says that? Can you show us the book, chapter, and verse where the Bible says that?
No.
So you're speaking as yourself. You're not speaking, thus saith the Lord. You said you was a prophet. The prophet speaks, thus saith the Lord.
The Lord speaks.
That's a strike against you. You should be saying what the Bible says.
The Lord speaks to me.
Book of Isaiah, chapter 8:20. To the law and to the testimony.
The law and to the testimony. You have, where's your Bible at, prophet? Where's your Bible? In your heart. Okay, read.
If they speak not according to this word,
speak not according to this word, right? Read.
It is because there is no light in them.
There's no light in you, man. There's no light in you.
But he shines on me. That's the light I have.
The sun shines on you, right?
The only light I have is from him.
The sun shines on you, doesn't it?
I do things wrong. I poison my temple.
The sun shines on you,
God still loves because he loves all his children.
Do you know your people catch skin cancer and all type of shit just from the sun coming on them?
Everybody, I wish they could cure them all.
Yeah, man, the sun hates you, man. I mean, the sun hates you. I don't need the suntan.
So love me.
I don't need sunblock.
I get sunburned.
Yeah, I know you do. I know.
God.
Because you're a goddamn Edomite, man.
God lets me heal.
You're a mutation, man.
God lets me be healed.
Your people are Frenchmen, right?
Your people are Frenchmen.
French, Irish, and Turanian. On your father's side. What's your father?
French and Turanian.
So, what is his father?
His father was God, too.
Huh?
My father was the greatest man. My father sent me an earthy father.
Yeah, what's your earthly? I'm talking about your earthly father.
I could make a pimple out of his ass by the time I
was. All right, see, homosexual.
This is Joel chapter 18 and 13. It shall devour the strength of his skin.
That's what you did.
Even the firstborn of death shall devour his strength.
So look, right? Your people, right? Y'all rape,
mind, your mind,
rob,
your
and
mind
murder.
Is
that's all you do. Now you just call you just pointed to your ass to a whole other grown
I said
ass.
I hope I can be as good as my father, but I don't think I can be as good as him.
What you wanna be a better raper than your father? You wanna be a greater degenerate than your father?
I wish you had one.
Right. Oh, you wish I had a father. Oh, black people don't have fathers, right?
No,
he's racist.
He's racist.
Oh, no. Hey, if you got hate in your heart, let it out. And move your French ass back, man.
All right?
When your people get close to my people, bad things happen.
That's right.
This side, on this side of shit, the bad things are going to happen. All right?
You want to hear something?
This is the book of Isaiah 14:21. Prepare slaughter for the iniquity of their fathers. Prepare slaughter for the Frenchmen. Right? They killed the Levites. God damn the Frenchmen. God damn the Irish. Alright? Read it again. Prepare slaughter for his children. God said prepare slaughter for his children, man. Your father's children are going to die. Right? Read it. For the iniquity of their fathers. The iniquity of their fathers. So all the rape, robbing, murder that your people done, your forefathers done, you gonna have to pay for that, man. Right? Because you are your forefathers coming back in reincarnation, man. All right? Somebody give me Galatians 6 and 7. Right? It's called karma. Right? And it's gonna be a hell of a lot of karma for you and your people. All
right?
Talk about you some goddamn Daniel the prophet.
Where
you scroll at, nigga? Read. It's the book of Galatians 6 and 7. Be not deceived. Be not deceived. God is not mocked. For whatsoever a man soweth, the French sowed what? Rape, rob, and murder, right? To my brothers in Haiti, right? Read. That shall he also reap. That shall you also reap, man. So you're going to reap what your people have done, man. The blacks, lads, and Native Americans, man. That's what you got coming towards you, man. Death and destruction to you, man.
That's right.
The hell is wrong with you? You running around, you walking around on stolen land freely, man. All over Native American bones. And got the nerve to come up here and speak to a black man that way? You out your goddamn mind, man. You speaking to God right now, nigga. You're in the presence of God. You need to be bowing.
That's right.
Dumbass. Good. It's the book of Ezekiel 35:5, because thou hast had a perpetual hatred and hast shed the blood of the children of Israel by the force of the sword in the time of their calamity, in that time that their iniquity had an end. Therefore, as I live, saith the Lord God, I will prepare thee unto blood. Prepare thee unto blood, man, because Numbers says what, man? This land can only be cleansed by the people that have shed blood, man. That's the only way this land gonna be cleansed, man. Right? So these people have to die.
That's right.
Read the Bible.
That's right.
Recompense. People say that's just, right? That's justice. Your people did horrible things to my people, and now you gotta be paid back for it. You haven't been paid back for it for a whole damn millennium, man.
Right?
Y'all been having it made in the shade, man. Out here, all stolen land, drying up like a goddamn California raisin without a goddamn care in the world. Right? Now, he said that God told him something, right? He talked directly to God. That's what he said. We have it on camera. Let's see what the Bible has to say about that. Read.
This is the book of John, chapter 5, and verse 37. And the Father himself, which has sent me, hath borne witness of me. Ye have neither heard his voice at any time.
Ye have neither done what?
Ye have neither heard his voice at any time.
A cigar, yeah. Is that red leather?
That is red leather.
Oh, that's Christ speaking, right? Read.
ye have neither heard his voice at any time, nor seen his shape.
So Daniel, you're full of shit, just like Gerardo was full of shit. All right? The Bible don't say what people be saying, man. Right? So they come up here full of their own vain nonsense, right? And just spew a whole bunch of nonsense that he can't give me book, chapter, verse on, man. You gonna come up here, you gonna have to come correct, man. Right? But, go ahead.
Yeah, man. That's what we got, man. See? I always want to be a part of the of our thing, man. And saying, but word to FBG Duckman. This is a real nigga party. And damn it, you cannot get in, man. Right? I don't care how many Bible verses you know. I don't give a damn how much money you throw out. I don't give a damn how much you come and spew a whole bunch of nonsense. You cannot be a part of this fold, man. You cannot cross this line, man. Okay? You know what your precept?
Because he has said that that God loves him. This is Romans chapter 9 and verse 13. As it is written, Jacob have I loved, but Esau have I hated.
Man, Jacob have I loved, but Esau have I hated, man. Right? Coming straight out of the book, right? Precept in Malachi, man. Right? This is thus saith the Lord right here, man. The Lord doesn't love Esau, man. He only loves Jacob, man. He loved Jacob. He gave the promises to Jacob, man. Alright? Read.
Malachi 1 and 3. And I hated Esau.
And he hated Esau, man. Right? That's something passionate, man. To hate somebody is a passionate thing, man. Right? So how can you now come and say that you're a prophet? The Lord chose you to be a prophet? Yeah, he chose you to be a damn false prophet, man, in your mind. Read.
And laid his mountains and his heritage waste for the dragons of the wilderness.
Everything that Esau has ever built up, right? It always fell at the end of the day, man. Keep reading.
Whereas Edom saith, we are impoverished, but we will return and build the desolate places. Uh-huh. Thus saith the Lord of hosts, they shall build, but I will throw down. And they shall call them the border of wickedness.
Yeah, man, they shall build, but I will throw down. Even if you make America great, right, through the blood of the Native Americans, the so-called Mexicans, the Seminole Indians, the tribe of Judah, right? The Lord is still gonna destroy this place, man. Right? Because it was built on nothing but lies. It was built on nothing but blood. It was built on nothing but rape. You know, it was this place is destined for destruction, man. Right, so the Lord said that you shall build, but he will throw down, man. America is slated for destruction, man. Read.
This Habakkuk chapter 2 and verse 12. Woe to him that buildeth a town with blood.
Yeah, man, woe to him that buildeth a town with blood, man. Woe to him that says, make America great again, man. Because we know that America was only great through us, man. Right, through us building this place up, man. Through us dying for this place, man. Right? So woe to this place, man. Woe to America, man. America has to go, man.
That's right.
Hold on, read.
Woe to him that burdeneth a town with blood and establisheth a city by iniquity.
Establish a city by iniquity. Rape, robbery, and murder, man. Right? The three components that made America great to begin with, man. Right? We are standing on the bones of our brothers right now, man. Right? And nobody seems to give a damn. Read.
This is Zechariah 2, verse 8. For thus saith the Lord of hosts, after the glory hath he sent me unto the nations which spoiled you. For he that toucheth you toucheth the apple of his eye.
Yeah, man. So you have hell to pay, man. Right? For touching God's chosen people, man. Right? For taking Israelite women and tying the trees by their feet and tearing the baby out the stomach. And dashing them on stones, man. Right? For going to take little Israelite babies and feeding them to alligators, man. Right? For them taking a powerful king of an Israelite man and subjecting him to mandingo fights and raping him, right? Emasculating the so-called black man, right? Through all forms of warfare, right? Biological, right? Physical, right? Psychological. Right? All manners of warfare that was used on our people, man. Right? So you are slated for destruction, man. Because you've offended the Most High at the end of the day.
It's the book of Jeremiah, chapter 22 and verse 13. Woe unto him that buildeth his house by unrighteousness.
Yeah, man, building his house with unrighteousness, man. America wasn't built through means of righteousness, right? Just look at the history. You could put the Bible down and just go into history. I can ask anybody on the street and they say, and ask them, how was America established, right? Plus they're gonna try to keep it PC and try to say through colonization, right? They don't want to say the real stuff, that this place was built through slaughter and rape, right?
Woe unto him that buildeth his house by unrighteousness, and his chambers by wrong, that uses his neighbor's service without wages, and giveth him not for his work.
Yeah, man, you just forced the Native Americans, the Mexicans, right? You forced the African American, so-called African Americans, to work, right, with no wages, man. Right, you forced the Haitians to work on sugar and coffee plantations, man. Right, with no wages, man. Right, woe to you, man. Woe to you that's riding around in a damn Lamborghini truck, right? Benefiting off of the rape, robbery, and murder of your forefathers, man. Because that's the only reason why you could even do that. Right, we're still suffering from what our forefathers have been through, man. Read.
Job 20 and 19. Because he hath oppressed and forsaken the poor, because he hath violently taken away an house with which he buildeth not, surely he shall not feel quietness in his belly. He shall not save of that which he desired.
Yeah, man, you're not going to be able to keep whatever you got, man. It's over with, man. It's only for a limited time only. We're going to get this last precept, we're going to go back to our people, man. Done talking about the devil.
This is Jeremiah 22 and 17. But thine eyes and thine heart are not but for thy covetousness, and for to shed innocent blood, and for oppression, and for violence to do it.
Yeah, man. So with that, man, these other nations are finished, right? Because they've done something that can't be forgiven, and it's high time that the tables get turned.